Adventure International presents. What do they present? Come on then. Missile attack. Oh, the Cornsoft Group. Philip Oliver and the Cornsoft Group. As you can see, it appears that we're dealing with some sort of missile command clone. And it's very nice. It's actually quite playable and enjoyable. I dare say, apart from the fact that the sound is doing weird things to my ears, this is the most fun I've had on the TRS-80 games that I've played thus far. But that sound problem is not to be understated. Okay, so that was apparently one of the shooty things. Defense bases, and the other one. Ah, here we go. P. Because that makes all the sense in the world. P. Oh, no. Yeah. No, it's I. Okay, we're about to be... I think we destroyed our defense base there. Okay, so I and spacebar. The two most illogical... This plays really well, though. I mean, I don't play it well. But it, as a game, plays really, really well. No, don't kill Brisbane. No, don't. Don't just be nice to him. No, I've lost all my cities. No. No. Well, we narrowly escaped that one. Do we get a city back? Oh, ow, 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 oh, ow. Oh my god, this is like Polaventris. Oh man. My mind is being reprogrammed as we speak. I'm gonna have horrible nightmares. Okay, that was missile attack, and it's really good. It's a really good missile command thing. Apart from the fact that I'm now some sort of CIA, sleeping whatever. It was a fun game, but the Polaventris ending was a little too much.